Go to the neighborhood, and I think we can pull it up from there. I think it's this one. Oh, you actually have to buy them, that's right. This is where you do it. Okay.
How's it
After
going?
the ridiculous layup move that I missed, we're going to do layups, and well, I think there's another one I want to work on. I think we're close to. Catch and shoot.
All right, AI, let's get everyone over here and get started. Here's what we're going to do.
Let's get started, man. Let's get started.
Ah, I missed that. Oh wow, I got lucky.
Alright, on to the next one.
It was decent.
Hey, hit me up.
Layups.
All right,
no, layups,
let's get to work. Here's what we're gonna do.
Focus.
Free throws.
Come on, AI, focus.
Get the next one.
There it
is. Pretend it never happened and get at it again next time.
Hey, hit me up.
Corner threes.
All right, AI, let's get everyone over here and get started. Here's what we're gonna do.
Turn it up! Turn it up!
Hey, he's ball, huh?
Hey,
stay up!
Hey, hey, balance it out!
Really, AI? Get your mind right.
Thank you.
just like that.
Not your best effort, AI, but certainly not your worst.
Hey, I'll see you later.
Okay.
Alright, AI, let's get to work. Here's what we're gonna do.
You got it, you got it. Come on.
Yeah, let's go, let's do it!
Moving, gentlemen.
Good boy, good boy.
See you later.
Okay, let's do it. Best game, baby.
And now we are here with Robbie and our special guest all the way from Australia.
It's the 2K Sports pregame show.
Greetings, everybody. Welcome to 2K Sports. I'm Ernie Johnson here with Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny the Jet Smith. Tonight...
2K Sports welcomes you to the following presentation of the NBA.
All right, let's do this. Not in the starting lineup, but we're the sixth man. Means we gotta start playing better.
Yo, AI, you got a minute?
Oh, yeah, coach.
Come talk to me.
Just about to head out for warm-ups.
Look, I just wanted to say the coaching staff really appreciates what you've been doing for the team lately.
Oh, thanks. That's always nice to hear.
Absolutely. So with that in mind, coach is looking to expand your role. All right, we want you to be one of the first guys off the bench.
Oh, you mean like the sixth man?
Sure. Something like that. Just know that you're an important part of the team, all right?
All right. Thanks, coach.
Absolutely.
All right, being the sixth man, baby, let's go.
What better way to start Welcome, everyone, to the NBA on 2K Sports. Kevin Harlan here, and I'm joined by Greg Anthony, Clark Kellogg, and David Aldridge, who's reporting from the sidelines. Now let's send it down to David Aldridge, standing by from the sidelines. David?
Well, guys, we know it's been a...
Great reporting, as always, David. AI really credits Tatum for his development.
Yeah, and, you know, I remember Tatum when he was in the league, a very smart player, and it's nice to see he is guiding others, finding their way in the league.
Clark, back when you were playing, what were the biggest challenges over the first third of the season you found?
Well, the travel is always a challenge, particularly early in your career. Just
a group substitution here for the Lakers. Beasley's checked in for JaVale McGee. Brandon Ingram comes in for Kyle Kuzma. Ball's checked in for Harris. And AI is subbed in for Rajon Rondo. On the court for Minnesota, Jimmy Butler is out there with Rose. Then it's Gorgui Dang. And there's Anthony Tolliver. And it's Nunley in at the three, the small forward. Ball, the pass to Beasley. So they take the lead.
Ball, such a terrific passer. He seems to have a sixth sense. Nice feel, which is hard to teach.
There's a screen. Butler kicks to Rose. And it's Ingram with the rebound.
That's a surprise. I mean, really out of character for him to miss when the defense is not right up on it.
And LeBron James gets it to go.
Guys, he has been a major factor, big time, outstanding at getting quality looks and knocking them down.
And stolen by James. AI up top. He's covered by Rose. Over Rose. And the Lakers tack on two more. And guys, what do you think about the hustle stats here for the Lakers?
They've come out in attack mode on the defensive end. They've applied pressure and forcing turnovers.
You know, they've also shown some real tenacity here early on tonight, and it's paid off with a lot of second chance points.
Butler connects on the 17-footer. Butler's got 11 points.
No matter what the score is, his attitude has been perfect. I love his disposition. He has stayed in attack mode.
Here's AI. Played in with there a nice touch off the glass. And the Lakers lead by five.
They are just killing them on the interior.
Yeah, you can't say that with enough emphasis. I mean, the defenders are just not being aggressive enough down low. You got to play with some physicality in the paint.
Here's Rose. Here's Tolliver, and he's fouled on the shot. One free throw coming up.
Boy, I like watching him get after it on the glass now, staying active, and usually that leads to good things.
First trip to the free throw line for him tonight. Minnesota making a switch here. Jones has checked in. And Clark, a lot of great names to choose from, but who would you pick for your greatest Laker ever?
Wow, that's always tough when you have such a robust list, Kevin. I always start with Kareem whenever he's in the conversation because that guy was my idol as I grew up watching the game. So Kareem is there, Magic, Wilt, Shaq, Elgin and Jerry West, and Kobe. That's too many, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. Some great names there, though, Clark. You're right. Hard to pick just one. Now 8 seconds separating the two clocks. Shot clock at five. And the shot is long. Now here's LeBron. And the rejection by Jang.
And this is something you'd like to see more of from Jang, given his size and wingspan.
And so it's LeBron James making things happen for the Los Angeles Lakers. He totaled. The former number one pick overall in 2015, Karl Anthony Towns, spoke about the aspect.
Every single day we're thinking about how can we be the team that we need to be to not only make the playoffs, but to make it deep into the playoffs and give ourselves a chance of being a championship team. We have so much talent. We have great veterans. We have a...
Yep, one step at a time, Greg. That's the mindset to have.
Yeah, you can't have too much too early. But with Towns leading the charge, this team is in great hands.
All right, the second quarter beginning in just a moment. And what stands out to you from the Lakers in this one?
Hustling on that offensive glass. That's led to a number of second chance points.
And we know energy and effort go hand in hand, and they won't be denied playing with a bunch of energy, easily coming up with those offensive rebounds too.
And now, brought to you by Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go, let's reset our lineups. On the court for Minnesota, Gorgie Dang is out there with Anthony Tolliver. Then it's Jones. Then there's Derrick Rose. And it's Nunley in at the three spot. Rose kicks to Zhang. Outside Rose. Off the screen. Off the left rim and out.
Well executed. Great rhythm. You've got to finish that one.
Agree with you there, partner, because that screen really freed him up nicely, and that's a shot. And if you're a pro, you need to make that one.
And looks like the illegal pick was set. Yep, that's right. That'll get their attention.
Yeah, still moving a little bit when he set that screen. He'll argue that he was set, but I really didn't think so.
It was very close, and I wouldn't mind letting them play on that one. It wasn't blatant by any means.
And the Lakers making a change here. Caldwell Pope's checked in. AI with it, working on Jones. Ingram trying to get open. Outside Rose.
Or did I just miss it? I think I just missed it.
Second quarter of basketball, just over a minute and a half played. Lakers leading by four. Ingram kicks to Caldwell Pope. Lakers working the ball around now. Pass to Beasley. Ingram trying to get open.
Space,
and
baby.
That one is good by Beasley. Timberwolves have gone 1 of 3 to start out the second quarter. Zhang, a screen. They set the screen. Back to Jones. Whistle on the play. Bucket's good. He'll go to the line.
Gorgie Dang doing a nice job getting the ball to the open teammate there. Nicely done.
And for Tyus Jones, 3 gold medals playing for the U.S. national team throughout high school. He was Minnesota's Mr. Basket, a national title clerk in his lone season at Duke. I mean, this kid's already got a lot of hardware.
Yeah, he's got a cabinet full of hardware, and I think he's got a chance to develop into a really solid point guard in this league. Again, just 1 year of college, very early in his career. You got to give him time because he's shown that he can be a winner at the levels he's played at prior to the NBA.
And those are two teammates right there working in rhythm, one setting the screen and the other using it to get that separation.
T kicks to Wiggins. Towns, a screen on McGee. Wiggins outside, down low. Jones, no luck.
That's the kind of D you need when he's got the ball near the hoop. They were all over.
Releases. AI,
God,
no good. Timberwolves trail by 6. Down low. Outside Teague. Outside Towns. 6 to shoot. Let's a floater go. And it's Teague. That time on the assist by Towns.
How about the delicate touch from Teague? I mean, guiding these floaters in well past the defense. That's an art, folks.
And now the Timberwolves on the break. Wiggins with the ball. Foul call that time on the way up. That'll give him 2 chances at the free throw line here.
And really the defense fouling there to prevent the layup, but that's exactly what you need to do.
It is. I mean, no reason to back off and give him the layup. I mean, much better off making him go to the line.
And the Lakers making a change here. Harris has checked in. Timberwolves also changing it up. Taj Gibson's checked in for Gorgie Dang. And it's Butler in for Tyus Jones. AI left side. He sticks that one in from 20 feet away. AI's got his second basket of the night. Timberwolves trail by 4. T kicks to Butler. They set the pick. Towns a screen on Harris. Butler. And that's out of bounds. Minnesota will retain possession. Rajon Rondo is checked in for the Lakers.
Rajon Rondo. Get a break, yes, thank you.
And so it's the Los Angeles Lakers. And the second half about to start here in just a few moments. We are seeing a tremendous game from my enemy eyes. Checked in for Harris. Jang, he's checked in for the Timberwolves. And stolen by Jang. Inside, we've got Kuzma and McGee. Rajon Rondo is out there with AI. And it's James in at the threesome. That's the Laker five. And it's out of bounds. They say it was last touched by McGee. And a chance now to see how teams are faring across the league. Here's the latest edition of the Power Rankings. You take a look at the Timberwolves. They couldn't hold their position this week, but remain in the top 10.
And seeing where the Lakers are, they're just right now outperforming those preseason predictions. And that's because they're getting help from some unlikely sources.
And we're going to have a jump ball. It's tied up there.
Well, we know Luke Walton comes from the Warriors coaching system, was an assistant there prior to taking this Lakers position, and known for his sharpness as an offensive coach.
And the Timberwolves with possession here. Here's Butler. And that comes off the assist by Jeff Teague. Yes, Teague's got five assists in the game.
Great shot making tonight from Jimmy Butler. Looks like he's playing with a little bit of an edge.
Here's AI, and that one off the back of the rim and in. AI's got the lead up to nine now for Los Angeles. And with the Lakers wanting to play more up-tempo, it makes sense to have Walton guide the ship.
Yeah, I agree with you because he's knowledgeable, played on some really good teams, championship-caliber teams. I think as he grows as a coach and as this team grows together, they could be quite a group.
Just four to shoot. Here's Butler, and he hits it just before the shot clock expires. Butler's got six here in this quarter.
Butler very aware of the situation there. No time to spare at all. Saves him from the shot clock violation.
AI sets a screen for Rondo. And stolen by Jeff T. One-on-one fast break over Rondo. They grab their own miss. The shot, no good. Lakers leading by seven. Pass to LeBron. Inside. Wiggins with the block. Oh, wow.
Great read that time by Wiggins, anticipating the shot. Sends it out with return to sender postage.
Teague, the pass to Butler. Lays it up off the glass. Butler's got 26.
Again and again, they're dissecting the defense and creating those high-percentage looks from inside.
And even under pressure in close, I think they've still done a good job maintaining concentration and converting the opportunity.
Six on the shot clock. LeBron kicks to AI. But they recover it. James, the pass to AI. Kuzma with it, defended by Butler. Back to AI. Ball's knocked loose. Pass to Rondo. McGee a screen. Here's AI. Los Angeles with another miss.
This shot's just, it's not there right now. With this team leading, perhaps, you know, let's focus on some other areas of the game.
And breaking down some numbers here, the hustle stats for the Lakers.
The activity level defensively, I've really been impressed with. There's been an attack mode on the defensive end.
Another part of their game that's made a difference tonight is all the second-chance points they've been able to get.
Big group substitution here for the Lakers. Beasley's checked in for JaVale McGee. Brandon Ingram comes in for Kyle Kuzma. Kentavious Caldwell-Pope, he's checked in for James. And it's Lonzo Ball in for Rajon Rondo. And there's the pass to Tolliver. Clark, give us a little insider's look. Which players do you look at as gamers? You know, guys who are always ready to put out extra effort and go the extra mile.
Man, there's so many guys that fall into that category, Kevin. It's almost unfair to try to pull some names out, but you look at the way they play, guys like Russell Westbrook, Draymond Green, LeBron James. I think Kevin Durant is much that way. He gives great, great effort and energy to his craft. Steph Curry is a little different, but still provides that and plays with such an exuberance and joy. You know, Marcus Smart is a guy who I think does all the little intangible things that just have a way of making a positive impact on his team. So I don't have enough time to give you the full list, but those are a few of the guys that come to mind.
Yeah, great example.
Just solid. Really one of the very best there is at the free throw line.
Caldwell Pope outside. Beasley the screen. Off the pick, Caldwell Pope shoots. And he connects with the jumper. Caldwell Pope's got his first basket.
Crafty and smart, capitalizing off the screen. Caldwell Pope, as soon as he gets the pick, he's ready to shoot.
Rose with the ball. Guarded now by Michael Beasley. Can't hit the step back jump shot.
You know, Kevin, his team is struggling a bit right now. I mean, I hope he can find his rhythm and start making his shots out there soon. Otherwise, ..
Top of the key ball. Caldwell Pope dishes to AI. And that one hits back iron.
He's been anything but his usual self this quarter. It's actually been ugly to see.
And now Rose running the floor all by himself.
Come on, Ingram.
And when he sets his mind to it, Derrick Rose is able to...
Wow.
And here is Los Angeles now. Their biggest lead of the game was 9.
Uh-oh, a little showboating at the end of that one.
Timberwolves trail by 4, so on the floor for Minnesota. Gibson plays the 4 with Towns in the middle. Teague runs the point with Butler at his side. They're the backcourt, and it's Tolliver in at the small forward position.
Not sure what the D was doing there. Clearly a breakdown. You can ill afford to give a guy like him that good a look.
And, you know, even though they're up, he's been off his game this quarter, having trouble finding the basket.
Outside, Towns. Butler against Harris. Butler kicks to Gibson. Over Harris, the Timberwolves again can't hit. Los Angeles leading by 4. Lakers passing it around. And AI with the basket on the assist by LeBron. James has got his 4th assist with that last one here tonight. Minnesota's gone 1-3 from outside the arc since we've reached the 4th quarter. Butler sets a screen for Towns. Towns the screen. And 2 free throws coming up. Unable to get that one to go with all the contact.
And Teague is a little reserved, but he's a natural leader, a guy who commands respect,
stick with guy,
I think,
man.
On both ends of the floor.
The first one falls.
And even though they're down, they are putting on a show at the free throw line.
Yeah, they're making the most of their opportunities at the stripe, and they'll need to keep it up to take the lead.
Wiggins is checked in for Minnesota.
And as you would expect from the way he plays, Teague is a terrific free throw shooter.
To the paint. Harris's shot is good. Harris has got 27 points.
It just seems like the more he touches it, the more the lead grows.
Teague, the pass to Towns. Towns is doubled. It's hauled in by LeBron. LeBron's got his 7th rebound of the game with that last one.
Their game plan needs to change if they're going to get out of this hole, because he is just not there offensively.
Timberwolves trail by 9.
Doing great.
T kicks to Towns. The kick out to T. Another miss by Minnesota. The Lakers shooting straight 49% from the field. LeBron passes to Kuzma.
And that monster lead continues to grow. They are just piling it on now.
Yeah, it looks too easy for him. Almost looks too easy for him, I should say, Greg. I mean,
their
chemistry
is
really, really at a high level.
Towns down low, guarded by McGee. McGee with the block. And Harris, wide open, he shoots. Good, and the assist goes to James. 30 points for Corey Harris.
Boy, this final period, they are putting up a ton of shots.
from deep.
And knocking down a bunch of them, too. Outstanding shooting in this fourth quarter.
Minnesota calls timeout. They're trailing by 14. 1:41 left in the fourth quarter. Now the presentation of our Jordan player of the game, LeBron James.
Sensational game for him in terms of shooting efficiency. He's taken nothing but high percentage shots. That's how he's managed to hit over 60% from the field. I mean, making just about everything he's looked at.
And this is exactly what a star player is supposed to do. Coming off a loss, he made sure they weren't going to make it two in a row. And McGee kicks to AI. Five on the clock. LeBron James on the wing. And he hits it just before the shot clock expires. LeBron's got 25 points in the game. Timberwolves trail by 16.
And this is going to end in a lopsided victory. I love the tenacity and aggressiveness as well as the ability to close. You really got to give it up here for the Lakers.
Tonight, they did a great job of getting everyone involved. They had the good passing, and that led to some open shots.
Solid play, definitely, Kevin.
And now, for the year, this is going to take them to 7 wins.
And once the horn sounds, they're going to go up 2-0 in the season series.
But, Greg, still 2 more games upcoming between these teams, so we could have a few more twists and turns down the road.
And one of the key components to this victory, if not the biggest, was the incredible performance for LeBron.
And the way he was able to dice up their D with his passing really made things easy for everyone else on his team.
Foul call that time on the way up. That'll give him 2 chances at the free throw line here.
And, you know, Butler has elevated himself to one of the game's all-star players, an all-around player who thrives on competition.
And he knocks down the first one.
Butler puts up 30 points, but we've just been playing good defense.
And so Butler nails both of them.
You know, and Butler wasn't a starter until midway through his second season. But since then, his minutes have gone up, and his productivity has gone way up.
Here's AI. It's rebounded by Towns. Here's Jones. So it's Los Angeles winning this one easily. They poured it on tonight. Dominant showing in front of a crowd that loved every minute of it.
And, you know, this game could really be a defining one for what...
Layups. Timers. Finishers. Defensive stoppers doing work. Four rebounds.
That's what I'm talking about. Good game, baby.